Hello everyone, today I am going to make a t-shirt design, but the focus for this video is explaining the transparency, because still now I get some request for explaining the transparency process. So yesterday I made a video for our country people in our language, and that was like whoever is following my channel from different countries, they didn't understand. So this one I am going to explain the process. I am going to make something like this, but not this exact same design, because this one is already I made for my other channel. So I am going to use this same vector pack here, and I am going to add some more elements here. This one is from Freepik, it's premium, but I will give you this one so you can use on each and every one of them in your different designs, so that will not be a copyrighted things. So let's start the process. I don't need this one, that was just to show you. Okay, so for starting the design process, we need to make some idea. So my idea for this design is I'm going to use this text here. So I'm going to make this, sorry for that, this fishing body a center point, a focus point. Then mines call me dad. I'm going to use this dad as another focus point. Then the rest will just follow my text. So I'm using this one here. Okay, I get a request for sharing this script. That is I'm using right now. Divide text from, you can search it on Google, or I will just add it in my Facebook group. So that's it. Now for this kind of design, I wanted to create a center point for my text first. Then I will create a center point for my graphic. Now as this fishing body is going to be my first focus point, I'm going to focus on this one. So I will use something like a font called Old Sport Athletic NCV. Okay, this font I'm going to use for my this design. Now you can see my keyboard strokes here. So this is going to be the focus point of my first. This is going to be the first focus point. Now mines call me. I want to make this one a little curvy text. So let's use maybe arrow kits. That is good. That font is really good. I like it. Something like this. Just a little bit overlapping with each other. Then for this dat text, I'm going to use this same text here. So as you can see, this is just a baseline I am creating here for making a base point for my this design. Now I wanted to explain the transparency. So transparency is a mask. What is a mask? This is a rectangle here. If we need to delete a part of a rectangle, we can use our eraser tool, shift E for eraser tool. Now if I erase it, I can erase, or maybe I can press alt to erase like this. I can press shift to erase perfectly precisely, but when we are erasing anything, that part is gone. So when we will save this document, once we save this document, we cannot go back to this position. Like I want to bring them back, but I cannot do that because that is erased and I already saved the document. So you can go back until you haven't saved the document, but there is another way we can work without erasing, that is called the non-destructive way. So if I don't want to erase it, then I need to make it look like it is erased. So if I take a rectangle here, something like this, then make it white, you can see it is looking like that part is erased, but it is basically a white color on top of the black. So my background is white, that is why it is looking like this part is erased. We can do this same using transparency. So if I take this rectangle, cut it, and then if I select anything, I can open the transparency option for that one. We can simply go to make mask or double click here. See, if I double click here, it will open like this. Now what is opened, as you can see, we cannot see that black rectangle here, because the problem is here is a black rectangle we can see covering the view. So if we turn this off, then we can see our black rectangle. but we cannot select it because it is inside the transparency. So I am going to click here on this white area. Then if I press Ctrl F, it is going to paste that same white rectangle. You can see here that is white inside this area. But the rule says whatever we paste inside the transparency, that must be black. So I am going to make this white rectangle black now. And as you can see, when it is black, it is making that area invisible. So if I click here, then if I bring this to a black background, you can see that part is erased, not basically erased, but that part is hidden. So we use transparency for hiding any part of our design, and that's the transparency mask. So it will be explained well when I will make the design, but let's focus on the design here. So this is the text here, mine fishing buddy, mine calls me dad. So for this text here, I am going to create some effect. What kind of effect? So I want to, first of all, I am breaking the font here. Okay, let's keep the font here so that we can sample those font. Now I am breaking it. Okay, once it is broken, as you can see, my this text, if I select these two, align them center wise. Now this text is overlapping my bigger text, upper text, and that is not looking very good. If we want to make this text visible completely, we can select this fishing text, press Shift E for eraser tool. Then if we just erase a little part from here, you can see we can make that area visible. Like same here, if we just erase some part from here, we can make that area visible. So this is the erasing part. Now if we work like this by erasing, we can do it, but if we want to come back after saving, we cannot. So in any point, if I feel like I need to bring those area back that I erased, I cannot. So that's why we use transparency. So I'm going back. Now for using transparency, first step is, okay, let me make it a bit bigger, just like this. That is good. Okay, so first step is, when we want to erase an area, we need to make a bigger shape. Like if we just create this same size shape, it will also overlap the text and it will not be visible. So that's why we need a bigger shape. So for a bigger shape, we create offset path. So go to object path and then offset path. Take a 10 pixel offset path. That is good. Click OK. Now as you can see, we have two shapes here. One is our original shape and one is bigger than the original, and that is on top. We need to cut that because I am not clicking anywhere, just Ctrl X to cut. Now we have a bigger shape in our clipboard. If I select this text, this fishing body text, I can open that transparency. Double click, clip. Now if I place that bigger shape inside this area, just by pressing Ctrl F, as you can see, that bigger shape is pasted here, and when it is bigger, it is making a empty space here, and that is why my this text is now visible. Like this O, if I click here, you can see that is a bigger shape inside the transparency, and that is making this area, making this gap here, and that is making this lower text visible. So that is good for my this design, and that's when we use transparency. We can do so much more things with transparency. We'll discuss that in a bit. For this one here, I'm going to just keep it as it is. Maybe I will make this one a bit bigger, a little bigger in size, because we have some area there. So for this one here also, I'm going to make it a little bigger with my this F text here. Maybe I will press Ctrl R for ruler. I can put a ruler here. You can see it is matching, so that's good. Now that is an effect I wanted to create. That is good. Now for this area, I wanted to, okay, that is not looking good, so let's bring that back just like this. So I want to create a base point here for the graphic. So I'm going to select these two text, make them a group. Now I am taking a rectangle here just like this, then press Shift X for making this in a stroke. Now if I make it bigger in a stroke size, that is good. Now as I make them a group, these two text, if I select this rectangle and my text, I can simply align them center wise just like this. Now I need to select them again and then group them. Control G to group them. That is good. Now I am going to apply some effect. So go to effect, wrap, and then arch. Arch is a good effect. Not that much, just a little bit, maybe 10 to 20%. 20% is good. Let's press OK. So this is making this arch here. Now I want to use maybe this dead text here, something like this, but let's make it overlap my that rectangle lower part, something like this, selecting them, aligning them center wise, just like this. That is good. Now when we are applying any effect here, we need to like expand it. So go to object, expand appearance. Now for this dead text, let's just bring that a bit down. So that is good for me. Now I am going to, as you can see, this part should be, I wanted to make it overlap with my this rectangle lower part, so that is overlapping. Now if I make a bigger shape of my dead text just by making an offset path, that's good. Cut. Now selecting this group, open the transparency, press Ctrl F. So it is pasted in front, and as you can see, this area is looking like some cut out effect, and that is making my text completely readable. So that is good. Now if you want, you can hide these parts too, like take the pencil tool, draw a random shape here. Of course, if the shape is in black, it is going to hide. So that's it. That's it for the text of the text of this part. That is good. Now I wanted to create some graphic area here, like something, a fishing scenario, my fishing buddy. So maybe I will use this one. Then I need to create another text, maybe Explorer, Condensed, Regular. That is a good font. So I wanted to create, make it the same like angle arc here. So if I go to effect, wrap, and arch, it is going to pick that same measurement from our previous work. So that is it. It is going to match with my this side of the rectangle, just like this. Then maybe a bit close to each other. Okay, so as you can see, some people wait a lifetime. This is going to be my upper text. I'm going to keep it as it is for now. Now if I just go to, as you can see, this area is like a open area. I wanted to make it, or maybe just I can double click to select this rectangle here. I can make it just bigger so that it fits in the, okay, that is not working like that, no problem. I'm going to create, take my pen tool here. If I click here, then press shift to click here, then press shift to click here, and then don't lose it, keep it clicking, then adjust the curve here. I think that is good. Now I am going to click here to discontinue the line. Now press shift and just click here to align that with my this text. So that part is good. Now I am going to make it a bit smaller because that is overlapping my rectangle line. So that is good. Now let's expand the appearance because we applied some effect. So this much is good for me. I think this part is done. I'm going to make them a group here. Now I want to create a fishing scene for the graphic area. So for a fishing scene, I want to use some of these elements from here, from my previous video. So let's bring them in here. Now I want to, okay, let's keep them this side. As you can see, there is some white parts in our design. So I want to fix that. If I double click here, I can go inside the group now. Then if I take my magic wand and click on this white, it is going to select all the whites here. Ctrl X to cut. Now I am isolating the group. If I select the group again, open the transparency and press Ctrl F to paste those white lines inside here. But as you can see, these are white, so it is not visible. And as I told you, it should be black inside transparency. So if I make it black, it is going to make those area visible, and that is how we are going to get a on color design, but with all of our details, like the details was in white. So same for this one also. If I just zoom in here, you can see there are whites. So if I select the white with magic wand, cut. Now I want to hide those parts. So I am selecting the fishing rod. Open the transparency, Control F to paste in front. Now it is going to paste everything that was in white inside this area. Now that is not looking good because it should be black. So when it is in black, you can see the details are back here. So that is good. Click here, make it black. So as you can see, everything here is now in black. So first step is I am going to make a scenery here for a fishing kind of scenery. So for that I need to make it arc, because I want to create a curve line here. So I'm keeping this fishing rod like this. Then if I go to effect and then arc, maybe a bit more, 30% arc, just like this, that is good. Okay, now we need to expand it because that is the effect we applied. Now if I make it straight like this, it is going to look something like that. Then I'm going to bring a copy here, right click and then transform, reflect. Okay, so I need to select these two, align them center wise, that is good. Now for the side area here, if I bring a ruler, I can align that with my, like with the wide of my rest design, and I want to keep everything inside the design area just like this. So that is good. Now here I want to create a effect that will look like some kind of fishing scene here. So I want to create something like this man is fishing. Okay, not that man, I will not use that man because that I used in my previous video. So I am going to use this one here, this man fishing here, as this is a father and son design. So I wanted to use something like a father and a son together fishing together like that. So I'm going to select this vector here, copy. Then if I just test it here, Control F, that is good. Now I am going to right click, transform and reflect. So that is good. Now I want to keep this man just like something like sitting on the bank, and then his son is going to catch a fish like this one, Control C. So I am going to make it something like this, but I need to work on the proportions to make it look real. So something like this. This is the main graphic theme here. Now I wanted to use a fish here, this bigger fish. So let's use the fish here. Now I wanted to use it like in bigger shape, something like this, but that is too much big. Let's use it smaller in size. Okay, something like this will work for us. Then for the son here, he also should have a fish. So let's use this one, Control C, Control V to paste. Now for the fish here, I want to just, okay, let's erase the man. My eraser tool is active, so I can erase it like with the rectangle like this. That is good. Now for the son here, this fish is going to be a bit smaller in size. Right click, transform and reflect, just like this. Then maybe, okay, I will just match the end of these two here, just like this. I'm pressing my arrow key to move that up or down. Now if I select these two, I can simply zoom in and press Shift M for shape builder. I can remove the part that is overlapping each other. So maybe select these two, make them a group. That is good. Now this is the main graphic area for my this design here. Maybe I will just use it in a way like this, not too much bigger but not too much smaller. So something like this. Now for this area here, I wanted to create a line like this is a fishing line. This man is holding this fish, catching this with this fishing rod. So I wanted to create a line here. Let's continue a line from this area like this, then bring that in front of the fish, something like this. Then I wanted to, okay, first step is I want to match the white here. So I'm using my white tool here. If I make it bigger like this, then press A for the direct selection tool. If I bring this, if I join this with my that fishing rod, I can also adjust the direction of that. And when we are making one side bigger, the other side becomes smaller. But for this one, I want this part to be a bit bigger, something like this. That will give us a feel like this is a smaller area going, and it is in front of the fish, it is going to look like that. So that is good. Now I want a kind of a fishing related, okay, let me bring one. Okay, let's not waste our time. I am going to use this one from here, then Ctrl C. I'm going to paste it here, something like this, but I want to erase this part. I want the fish only, just like this one. Then maybe a bit tilted in this way, something like this, just to make it a feel like this fish is going to just swallow that one, just like this. Okay, I need to do it perfectly because this area is sensitive. So something like this, just to give it a feel that this fish is going to just catch that one. Okay, so that part is done for us. Now I want to just keep everything in a group. So I'm selecting these three, this man, child and the fish, and the rest of things in a group, Ctrl G. Now for this area here, they should not just stand something like on this area. We should make a area for them, like a place where they are standing. So I am making a line here. This is going to be the horizon line for my this design, something like this. Okay, maybe a bit downwards, just to give it a feel like this is the landmark. And then another line like this. This is going to be the horizon line of the water, like this is the water or lake, something like that. This is the land they are standing and sitting on lands. So maybe this one a bit down like this, that's good. Now I want to create a copy here, then press Ctrl D for making some more copies, just until it fills the whole area. Now I need to select them all. Just like this, not the last one and not the top one, just the lines in the middle. And then if I just, okay, I didn't select that one. If I just make it something like this, it is going to cover the area. I am making them a group here, Ctrl G. Now go to effect, distort and transform, zigzag, turn on the preview. It is going to make them like some water kind of effect, but I want to make it smooth, something like this. Okay, that is too much roundness there, something like this. Okay, that is not going to look good because I need to break these lines. These are all continuous line, so if I break them from some areas like this, I'm using my eraser tool to break them, just like this. They are in a group, so it is going to act like it is just acting like a group, but I want them to act like some water. So like this. Now go to effect, wrap, and then distort and transform, and then zigzag, turn on the preview. Now if I make it smooth, it is going to look like something like this. That is too much. Let's not mess with that part. Increase this part. just like this to make give it a water kind of feel. Now we need to expand it because that's the effect we applied here. Now this is maybe not looking very good right now because this part should look something like in the distance. So how we can represent that part in the distance? We can use some other graphics here, like this palm tree, maybe smaller. So here I'm going to place a palm tree, then another one maybe here. Of course this one a bit smaller in size because that is more far away from this one. Then maybe some palm trees here as well, but this one's in a bit bigger in size because this is just okay, not in this part. I don't need them here. So maybe a mountain here. Okay, sorry for that. I need this mountain to be here, but of course this mountain is going to be smaller. Now in this one I am making this mountain smaller than my palm trees because I want to make it give it a feel like this mountains are in the distance place, in a very distance, and then we can see the palm trees in front of them. So something like this, maybe a bit more bigger, so that will give it a feel like that is another part of the lake and they are just fishing in a lake like this. So that's good. Now I need to fix some areas here. Like if I select this one, you can see the mountain is visible through this one. That back mountain is very visible through this one. So I'm selecting this mountain, copy. If I select this one, open the transparency. Now I want to paste this mountain's copy here, Ctrl F. It is not making any difference, but if I make it merge and unite, it is going to make it a complete black shape. And when it is complete black, that is hiding everything that is behind this mountain. Just like this, this mountain is visible through this mountain. So we need to copy this one, then select this one, the one we want to hide. Now open transparency for that. Press Ctrl F to paste this mountain's copy in the front. Now merge unite to make it a complete single shape, and as you can see, it is how this is how it is looking right now. So if I click here, it is going to look like this. So that is good. Now for this one here, these palm trees here, I want to make them like a bit longer. So if I double click, I can individually select them. Pressing A for the direct selection tool, I can bring them down, like the down area. That's good. Now I want to bring them a bit up. I don't want to overlap them on this area, but this part should be matching with my mountains. So if I just bring them a bit close like this, just like this maybe, then taking my eraser tool to erase this part. That is good. Now I am selecting my mountain. Go to object path and then offset path. Okay, that is a bit bigger, make it 5 pixel. Cut. Now I am selecting this mountain. Inside of the transparency I will paste the palm trees offset path. It is going to look like that. So that is good. Now this is the distance area, this is the close area. Now for this area I need some, okay, so I need something to hide the area. Let's use something like grass effect here. So this pack will work for me. Now as you can see, this is free to download, but if this was even premium, that's not a problem, I have premium. So I'm just downloading that part here, wherever it is. This is just something comes in my mind right now. Okay, I want just a little details of the grass here, not too much detailed grass. Or maybe just use this one. Let's use the detailed one. So that is good. I'm pasting it here. Now for this area here, I just want them to stand on a land kind of thing, not in an empty space. So make a copy here, then press Ctrl D. It is going to make another copy here, just like this. And as you can see, this is not looking very good right now, but let's not worry about that. I am making them a group all together. Then go to effect, wrap, and then arch. It is going to make it same kind of arch 20%, because I have a curve in the in this area here, something like this, maybe a bit left. So that is good. Now I need to expand it, because whenever it is applying any effect, we need to expand it. So something like this. This is, this will give it a feel like they are standing on some kind of grass area, like some land area. Or I just want to make them make their feet height with this grass. So let's make the grass a bit bigger in size, just like this. Now this is a design, okay, so we don't need to just make it a very perfect one, just something like this. Now this part is not looking very good. Let's go to effect, arch again, this time a little bit, because that is already arched, something like this. So as you can see, this is how it is going to hide those areas from here, and we don't need it to be visible from this area. So we can simply press shift E for eraser tool. Now we can erase the part that we don't want. Now we can use, of course, the transparency here, but when it is sure that you don't need them, you can erase those part. Like this grass, I don't need them to be visible on this side anytime, not now, not in future. So I can hide those part. So that is the kind of thing I wanted to create here. But as you can see, the lines, waves are visible through my fish. Like this is overlapping the fish. I want to hide that. So if I double click here, I can isolate the group. Now I am selecting this boy and the fish. Go to object, path, offset path. Again, same, maybe 10 pixel. Let's cut. Now I am selecting my fish vector, because I want to hide this part, these little parts that is overlapping my boy and the fish. Now if I open the transparency, press Ctrl F, it is going to paste it here. And as you can see, so as you can see, this is hiding those area, but it should be perfectly black. And the reason it is not being perfect black, because this boy and the fish is not perfect black. If I make them black, then every time whatever I will do, it will be black. Now I want to select my this one. Then this was a stroke, right? We did a stroke here. I want to expand this stroke now. This one, all the three, I want to make them black. Then go to object, path, and then offset path. Make it something like this. Make it cut. Now again selecting the fish, because I want this rope line to be visible on top of my fish. Inside the transparency, press Ctrl F. It is going to paste those in front of my fish, and it is looking like this, like this rope is visible on top of my fish. So that is good, but I wanted to hide this wave lines. So I'm selecting my fish this time. Go to object, path, offset path, same size, 10 pixel. Let's cut. Now I need to select my this one, this group, and the everything. Okay, I don't need this lower line right now. I can simply just make it overlap. Okay, that's not important. So I'm selecting this one, and also this horizon line. I need this one this time. So I'm making them a group. Now every line here is now selected. So let's open the transparency for them. Press Ctrl F to paste that fish vector in here. But as you can see, this area is visible because the fish has some empty space in it. We need to make it a complete solid color vector. So for that, we need to merge and unite them. And when it is merged and united, as you can see, it is becoming a complete one color shape. And that is hiding everything that is behind this fish. And that's how, as you can see, my web lines are still there, but it is invisible, like this fish transparency is hiding those. So that is good for us. The theme here is good. Now I want to select my this one here, this group here. They are a stroke, so let's expand them. That is good. Now we don't need them to be on this part, so I'm pressing Shift E for eraser tool. Now if I just erase them from this area, it is going to be erased. Now I am sure that I will never need this part. Okay, the part that is overlapping my fishing rod. So that's why I'm erasing it. If you are sure about anything, you can erase it. And if you are not sure, then of course use transparency, because that will, you can always come back to that situation. So this is the final graphic for me here. My graphic work is done. This is the text part, and there was a another text left. So some people wait a lifetime. I just want to make it this font maybe, or just okay, let's use our Explorer font. That is good, but make it a bit smaller in size, because I want to just cover this area, this fishing rod tip to this fishing rod tip. So the easiest way is I can simply make a curve here, just like this. Then if I select cut my text, select this one, then go to type on path tool, click on this anchor point, press control V to paste. Now as you can see, this is pasted on that line. So something like this, that is good. Maybe a bit right, that's good. Okay, so that is good for my this area. Now it is looking like a complete close graphic. You can see this part that is making the lake kind of effect, making the distance graphics. Okay, this part I want to make some changes here. This should not be visible inside the lake. So okay, maybe a bit up, then I can erase it, something like this. So that is good. Now this is the final graphic for my this one, and as I just created a curve here, arc here, I can simply take my pen tool, okay, not like there, and then create a shape here, take another line here, then another line here. I am just filling the gaps that is created here. So I'm going to increase the strokes, of course. Then I'm going to use this option, which one? This one. So this is going to look like this, maybe a bit bigger. Now I want to expand it, because I don't need them to act like a stroke. Now in this side, bring them, reflect, just like this. So this is good. Now I can make them a group. This three, okay, so these three also I can make them a group. Then if I select this two, I can align them center wise, then bring them up. That will be in the same position for both side. Okay guys, so this is my final graphic right now. I am making this curve here just because I wanted to create this scenery kind of effect here. Now this may not look like a very professional orc, so that's not a problem here, because we are just focusing on the graphic here, and we are trying to make the scenery for this design. So that's it guys. I hope you enjoyed this one. I'll of course do some modifications on this design, then I will post in my group. You can see the final works there. So have a good time guys. See you in the next video. Thank you for supporting me. Have a good time.